Hi guys, this is Ollie from Reboot Online, and today we're going to be talking about how to create and upload a disavow file. What this will include is where you can find the backlinks pointing to your website, how to audit them to determine if they're causing your rankings any problems, and where you can upload your disavow file once you've completed it. So, to offer a quick summary of what a disavow file actually is, it's essentially a .txt file which contains a list of backlinks and referring domains pointing to your site that you don't want Google to take into account when determining where to rank your business. So I'm going to jump onto SEMrush now and we're going to start creating the file. So we use a number of tools here at Reboot to create our disavow files. The first one being SEMrush, which I've got open here. And this will essentially streamline the process and make creating your disavow file a lot quicker and a lot easier. We then have a few backlink monitoring tools, some of which integrate directly with SEMrush, like Google Search Console and Majestic SEO. And then we also use Ahrefs, which doesn't integrate with SEMrush, so you're going to have to open it up manually, export the links, and then import them back into the SEMrush tool. You can do that by heading over to Ahrefs here, putting your domain in. You can see I've got Reboot Online here, clicking Backlinks, Export, and then making sure you do a full export so you get all the links that Ahrefs has found. Once you've exported this CSV file, you can head back to SEMrush and import them directly by clicking Audit, Add Backlinks, and then selecting the CSV file. It will take a while for all the links to become available in the dashboard, but once that's done, you can dive straight into your disavow file creation. So I just want a quick overview of the SEMrush tool. In case you're not familiar with it, or if you've just started using it, you can get to this place by creating a new project for your domain and then enabling backlink auditing. Essentially what SEMrush does is it looks at every link listed in the tool pointing to your site and assigns it a toxic score. The toxic score helps determine if the link's high quality or low quality. They can then give you an overall toxic score of the health of your backlink profile. You can see the Reboot Online one's looking pretty healthy, only 38 potentially toxic links, but we're still going to want to go in and explore them further and decide if we want to add them to the disavow file, if we're okay leaving them. I should also explain the difference between domain and URL when it comes to the SEMrush tool. You'll see the options whether you're adding it to the whitelist or whether you're adding a link to the disavow or remove list. And basically what it means is if you're adding a domain to the disavow remove list, that you want every link coming from that website to be included. If you click URL, that means you only want that one page containing that one link to be added to whatever list you're selecting. Usually if you identify a website as a low quality one, you're going to want to add the entire domain to the disavow file just so Google ignores any links coming from that website. To start auditing the links in SEMrush, you're going to head to the toxic score. If you hover over it and click, you're going to see a number of factors listed why the domain's been assigned this particular toxic score. That will let you know if the link's high quality or low quality, and it will let you know why. You're also going to want to do some manual work. You don't want to be adding links that are powerful or that could be helping your rankings to the disavow or to the remove list. You can do that by opening them. When they load, copy it, and then I'd head over to Majestic and take a closer look at the website as a whole. I'd advise watching Shai's video on link auditing for a better idea on how to do this. So if we look at this one, we can see that it's got a trust flow of 0 and a citation flow of 16, which is an immediate red flag. It's also got a tiny number of referring domains compared to a huge amount of backlinks. This is pretty clearly a spammy website and not likely one we want Google to associate with our website. You can look at the individual backlinks again and see that they're all pretty low quality. None of them seem to be related to our topic, which is digital marketing. So we can be pretty confident that we'd want to add this one to the disavow file. We can do that just by heading to the tool, selecting it here, clicking delete, and then to disavow. You're also going to want to do manual checks on the websites, open them up just to see if they have any warnings, if they're poorly constructed, if they're relevant to your website, and just noticing if there's anything wrong. You can see SEMrush helps you do this by providing a snippet of the page title. You can quickly tell if any sites are irrelevant to you. You can also use SEMrush advanced filters and then select toxic markers. I'd suggest going with some of the more important or troublesome toxic markers like link networks or community warnings. Community warning is essentially if other SEOs have been using the tool and they've been adding these links to their disavow file, it's highly likely that you're going to want to do the same. So we can see by selecting this one, we have 33 domains listed. Immediately we can see there's some dissertation writing service sites, essay writing, personal statements. None of these websites seem to be relevant to us, and they're all pretty low quality in terms of toxic scores. So we can select them all, click delete, and add them all to the disavow file. This is how this tool really speeds up the process of creating your files. So once you've done going through all of your links, you're going to want to export your disavow file so you can upload it to Google. You can do that by clicking disavow at the top, waiting for it to load, and then clicking export. It's going to download it and you'll see it down here. If I just open that up, we can see there's a comment letting Google know that we've exported the link from a backlink tool. And then it dives straight into the domains and URLs that we want them to ignore when they're thinking about where to rank our website. So once you have this, you can then head over to Google Disavow Tool and upload it. I'd recommend that just by Google searching Google Disavow Tool and then logging into your account. If we click here, you'll see Google gives you a summary of the previous disavow file you've uploaded, if you have uploaded one. It will tell you when it was uploaded and how many domains and URLs were included in the file. We always like to download our previous disavow file, just in case you want to roll back and use the old disavow file. Maybe you've added some powerful domains to the new one by mistake. It just makes things a lot easier. So once you've done that, click choose file, find your disavow file, select it, and then you can submit. Thanks for watching. Remember to like if you learned something in this video, and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more tutorials from Reboot.